Okay, I'm gonna be on a traffic stop here, so be ready for 10-1 bugs. I'm gonna call it in here in a sec.
Alright.
If you want to start heading over to Mad Wayne Thunder and West Eclipse Boulevard in the 2012...
10-4, 1097, code 2.
Green okay. Witch, basically.
Alright.
Okay, hold on one sec.
Control Bravo 145. Go for the bank. 10-8, 1041. Copy.
1A1, 1011.
Copy 1A1, what's your location?
It's going to be Mad Wayne Thunder Drive and West Eclipse Boulevard, 2012, Mad Wayne Thunder. All right, I'm going to make contact. How's it going tonight?
Hey, how's it going? Hey.
Yeah, do you know why I stopped you tonight?
Yeah, I mean, me and my buddy, we're late to a movie shoot up in the hills, and, you know, we're kind of lost, we're foreign, we're just trying to get there, you know, we have time to make, you know?
Yeah, because on West Eclipse Boulevard back there, I saw you guys cutting in and out of traffic. You were using your horn. Really wasn't sure what that was about.
Yeah, well, that guy, okay, dude, shut up, man. You're going to get us, like... Okay,
so you said you guys are foreigners?
Well, he is.
Biden.
Okay, he's a foreigner. Other
he
than
does
that...
English.
He doesn't English. Okay. Do me a favor, let me get some identification from you.
Yep.
License, or proof of insurance, all that fun stuff.
Yeah, I just got to reach in the glove box. Is that all right?
Yep. Nice and slow for me.
Alrighty. Here is my license, here's my insurance, and then this is the registration for the vehicle. And my name is Jim Schmottenberg.
Alright, Jim, go ahead and sit tight for me really quick. We'll get everything squared away here in a sec, alright?
Alrighty.
Hey, what is on the hunt?
What do you mean, dude? Just be quiet.
Okay, 1-1 dispatch. I don't know if we have a dispatcher in here.
No.
Nope, we don't. Okay, well, you'll be my dispatch. 1-1 dispatch.
1-1, go ahead.
Can I get a 27 and a 28 on a Jim Schmottenberg?
10-4.
Dude, at least we didn't see the weed, man.
Looks like Jim Schmottenberg is coming back clean. Previous citations for reckless driving.
10-4. Yeah, he's seeming a little sketchy. Just the way that they're both acting right now.
Yeah.
It seems a little bit weird. I'm not getting any odors or anything like that from the vehicle, so I don't believe it's alcohol or drug induced. But yeah, exactly. But I just it's something's not sounding right.
Yeah.
So and yeah, they ran the red light, plus cutting out off cars with horns and stuff. So I say we could at least do a field sobriety test on this guy.
Yeah.
Just to see what's going on. All right, Jim. Really quick, I'm just not enjoying the way that you're out there driving and the way you're acting right now. So if I could just get you to step out, make sure that you're all okay to drive. If that's the case, then I will cite you, and you will be on your merry way. If not, we're going to have to talk on a different level, okay? So why don't you go ahead and step out really quick?
Well, I mean, I talk on lots of different levels. What kind of level would you be talking on?
Well, on this level, I'm asking you to step out. Next level, I'm going to be telling you to step out. And third, I'm going to be pulling you out. So how about we do this the easy way? Right. You just step out really quick. We'll do a field sobriety test. As long as you are A-okay to drive, you'll be on your road with the ticket.
Is there a hard way?
Yeah, that's me pulling you out of the car.
Okay, I'll get out. Can my friend stay in the car?
He could stay.
Maybe, you know, it probably, yeah.
I have no issue with him.
Okay, good.
He's not driving. It doesn't matter if he has alcohol in his system or not. It's just you I'm worried about. So let's go ahead and step out.
Get your foot there.
Perfect.
You put the filter.
Okay, go ahead and keep an eye on him really quick.
Yeah.
All right,
yeah,
so
I'm just waiting for that.
Go ahead and stand where I'm standing on the line right here.
Yes, sir.
Facing down towards my officer.
Yeah.
And stay there.
Uh-huh.
All right. Now, you're going to come all the way to where this patch of grass starts, and you're going to stay on that line, okay?
Gotcha.
All right, go ahead and walk that line for me.
You bet.
Okay. Go ahead and turn around and walk back the other way.
Alrighty.
Right where you started in the first place.
You bet.
Okay. All right, go ahead and step back in your car for me, please.
All righty. Good to find you. You know, I'm not.
What?
Get out of the car.
It's in the modern, okay?
They're speaking two different languages towards each other. Yeah, I don't know what they're doing.
One of them's English.
I know. I don't know what's going on.
One of them's English. One of them's garbage.
All right, you want to step back here so we can figure this out? All right. Well, I don't think he's under the influence of anything, and I really don't have any probable cause to get in the vehicle. So I'm just going to cite them, and I guess we'll let them on their way.
Yeah, that's probably best.
Okay.
Well, do you...
Keep the car still. Yeah, I don't know what he's doing. You want to keep the car still?
Yeah, it's a weird car. It's an old car.
Is it? Okay. Well, right now, I don't believe you're under the influence of any alcohol or anything like that, and I have no reason to go in the vehicle, so we're going to go ahead and get you out of here with a parking ticket, even though I decided to pull out the majorly big clipboard, but that's fine. Yeah, we're going to get you out of here with the speeding, or actually not speeding, I'm sorry, the red light violation and not using a signal. To change lanes properly. Other than that, do you have any questions or anything?
No, I have actually have one question. If we were to dress up as police officers for a video,
you'd go to jail.
Be okay?
No, no, wait, for what? For a video?
Film. It's for a film. In a film.
Yeah, we're actors.
So I thought you just spoke English, and now you are speaking English. So what's
no
going
English
on?
At all.
Is there more to what's going on here?
Okay, so I've been in, America for a few weeks now.
But before you didn't know any.
Do you have a
visa? Yeah, do you?
I know. FIFA?
Yeah.
Not FIFA, a visa.
I'm not Mexican.
No. Yeah. Visa. You know, to like legally be here.
I'm legal.
Okay, show me your visa.
What's visa?
That's the paper you need to legally come to the U.S. Because I'm assuming you're here on business, correct?
Business.
Yeah, so you have a business visa, which allows you to stay in the U.S. for a certain amount of time. And then once that visa runs out, you can't be here anymore and you have to return home because you're only here for work.
Yes.
So
you
if you...
buy a CD?
No. I would like to see your visa.
Yeah, we have CDs and hats. You want some of them?
I don't care about your CDs and hats. I would like to see his visa.
How about a nice bumper sticker?
How about we get everybody out of the car?
Interesting.
Yeah, this has escalated quickly.
It is. All I want is a visa. If this guy can produce a visa that shows that he's legal to be here, then I don't have a problem.
Well, I mean, technically, he's not. But he's a paid actor for our company, and,
And he's not from the U.S.
I'll tell you what.
Does that matter?
And he's visiting the U.S. while working. He's here to work.
Considering the fact that he is not driving the vehicle, and he has no obligation to give us an ID, if you take the ticket...
If he's not an American citizen, he needs to have a visa.
I haven't read up the ISIS book in a while, okay?
The ISIS book. All right. Yep. It's been a while since he...
Interesting.
The fucking ISIS book seems legit.
It's on you if this dude's illegal and we can't trace him back to any crime because he has no paperwork. But hey, if it's good with you, it's good to me.
If you really want to, take him back to your car and fingerprint him.
Hey, I'm white.
Get his fingerprint.
All right, fine.
All right, sir, why don't you go ahead and step out really quick? Okay, or you can bring it back there, or whatever one works.
I mean, I got a portable.
You can take that expensive machinery out, or you can bring
it back. It's portable.
Okay, that's fine. All right, so we're just going to have you give a fingerprint really quick.
Huh?
El fingerprinto. And if you speak any other language, I don't know it, so I can't translate.
Fingerprinto?
Yep.
Yeah, so this fingerprint thing look like a big clipboard, but it's not, so... Just
speak a little Spanish too, so if you speak Spanish, then...
Clearly, even though he just said he didn't speak Spanish, so I can see this guy.
Yeah, just stick your finger. There you go.
There you go.
Okay, so I got a fingerprint. Now I'm just gonna get a. Hang on, not yet. And let's. All right, grab a photo.
Oh.
Okay.
Smile.
All right.
Smile.
Okay. Yeah, I'm good.
All right. Well, you've received your tickets for those two traffic violations. You're gonna have to appear in court. You have no further questions, so you're free to go now.
Yep. All right. Well, We're going to go film our video.
Okay, well, be enjoy safe driving from now on. If you get caught, it's going to be reckless driving. You have the same stuff, so...
I have a question.
Nope. Let's go ahead and just get on out of here.
Yeah, have a good day. Adios.
Nope.
The cop is just like, hey, I have a question. Nope.
Nope.
Nope. No, you don't.
Oh, that's so good. Oh, yep, they just ran. Yep. That was a stop.
Are you pulling them over again?
Oh, yeah.
Who is this guy?
Get the fuck out of the way! I'm trying to get to the call! Yeah, they're asking for it. I'm gonna take this guy to jail for reckless driving. Can I take him to jail for reckless driving?
No.
He just now?
You can seize his vehicle. I don't even know if you can do that.
I know. I mean, we're doing that. That's so good. All right.
You can give another ticket.
I mean, I guess.
5-122.
Fuck. All right. I'm going to have to call this in. Hold on.
Yeah.
1-8-1-10-11. It's going to be Mad Wayne Thunder Drive. Same location, same vehicle. Different traffic stop. If I can get a 10-1 with the same.
Copy. Is 1-81
10-4. Yep. Alright, let's go ahead and take care of this guy now.
What are you gonna...
What? I don't know.
What are
you gonna... I'm gonna wing it. I have to wing it. I don't know.
Okay.
Hola.
Alright, what the hell are you doing? Why did you bust the stop sign? Don't even say anything. You're not the driver.
No,
Wait a second. Did they switch or are they still in the same spots?
Yeah.
What are you doing?
No words.
What do you mean no words? That's not how it works. You can't act. You can't get a ticket and then go and do another illegal thing by running a stop sign.
We're late, okay? We have to get this video done.
Okay, well you're gonna be even more late if I seize the vehicle.
You're going around and go south.
Okay, well I don't think that's gonna happen.
Well, if you keep driving like this and I keep pulling you over for consecutive stuff, even though I warn you not to, it obviously seems you're incompetent to drive.
Oh, I might be. Oh, great.
And it's rain. And it's gonna start to rain in your canis. There you go.
That's gonna be real nice. You know where is your destination? Where are you trying to get to?
The house up the hill.
Okay, because we left you. You went north and you flipped around and then went back south.
The GPS is being retarded.
But you already said you were going north, so why would you need to turn around to go back down south?
And then you're going to the house up the hill.
Can I ask a question?
No. So this is. That's great. So no, the thing that I have and I'm worried about is the fact that I just told you and I just caught you driving bad, and then you say that you received the ticket and you're gonna go do the same exact behavior again. What should I do as a law enforcement officer?
As a law enforcement officer, I think that you might want to get a jacket because it's starting.
No, I'll sit here in the rain and I'll soak it all up. My question is, what should I do with you? You're not impaired. It just seems like you're driving like a jackass for no reason.
Well, I might be driving like a jackass, but I mean, hold on, give me a few seconds to come up with a good excuse, officer.
I mean, at this point...
Just write him as many tickets as you can.
Okay,
I think those tires are technically too thin to be legal. Just look for everything.
I will. I also, it looks like he's driving with his the front of his vehicle unlatched in the hood, so...
The hood's, that's careless driving.
Okay.
Yeah, see, what I'm going to do is I'm going to... I don't think that's possible, but...
It's in the storage space. My boy's just got to get out.
No, he's not getting out of the car.
Question?
No. So, what don't you understand about this? Just no question for you. I want to figure out what's going on with this driver, because he seems like he's...
I'm fine.
Officer. Okay, then I'm going to write you about 3 or 4 tickets right now for one... actually, looks like you're not wearing a seatbelt, too.
I don't see any seatbelts.
Yeah, I don't see two seatbelts, so that's...
You know what? The institution for highway safety...
Did I say you could talk, passenger?
Yes.
No, I didn't.
You were the one who got us pulled over in the first place.
Control.
Control?
Okay. Yes. Okay, so this vehicle is old.
It doesn't matter.
Well, yes.
You're driving it on the roadways.
I want you to be safe.
If it's built before... Yes.
That's a lot of good English, you know, just to try to tell us this law.
Yeah. You're not even a citizen.
Yeah,
shut your mouth.
Up.
No more talking from you.
Yes.
Yes, exactly. All right. Good. All right,
get a
so
green
you're
card and then you
these.
Can tell us how to do our
good.
Job.
You're going to receive yes. these tickets. And then I yep. don't want to see you driving recklessly again, okay? Because if you get in an accident or if anything serious happens, I'm taking the vehicle. And you might be going to jail.
Okay.
Okay. Well, if we see you again on these streets, just know.
Okay.
Yep. Do what you want with your fingers.
Hey, officer. Okay, never mind. Whatever.
Okay.
Yeah, you're going to end up
yep.
arresting
We're
going to
see him again. Yep.
Yeah.
10-1 on the officers.
This is Paul 24 to 1A1 direct.
Go ahead.
I was dispatched as supervisor up to a situation near the Utul and St. Assurance. I'll relay that to you if you'd prefer to dispatch the supervisor.
You want me to go ahead and head that way? Is that what you're saying, or?
Well, I was dispatched as a highest ranking, but since you're active supervisor, I can hand that off to you if you want to take that call.
What is the call for?
Uniform 117, correct me if I'm wrong, it's going to be rowdy individuals on the highway.
It's going to be rowdy individuals on the highway refusing to comply along with suspicion of drug operation.
10-4, you copy that 181?
Yeah, go ahead and route 1A1 and 1A181 en route to that, code 3.
1A81 is going to be 1023.
Alright, we'll wait for 1A1 to get over here.
Alright.
Alright, how's it going? So, situation we got going on right now is, we got two individuals in there. They were stopped for 35 plus speed. And then we had, their failure to comply. They've mentioned many time operations. And then they've also mentioned, the pastor mentioned he didn't want his drugs taken. When asked to get out of the vehicle many times, they refuse, they lock the doors, and they refuse to get out.
Okay, do we know if there's drugs in the cars, or are they just hypothetically saying that?
They will not let us know at all.
Okay. If you ordered them out, then I guess it's time to break windows and we can...
Well, let's, like, code 5 them and just guns at them, order them out.
I mean, yeah, we could try that. If not, then we could at least breach in and pull them out or whatnot.
If you guys want to set up your vehicles for the code 5, we'll pull in behind you, cover your flanks.
Okay. My vehicle's up front.
Okay.
Why don't you leave yours there and let them form the pyramid?
I'm just going to go ahead and get in with the SUV, and we'll just use the other SUV that's up there and this SUV. We don't need more than one.
All right.
Okay.
Are we all good?
Yep.
10-4.
Someone want to give commands, or I will?
You can.
Okay, driver, if you could hear me, go ahead and step out of the vehicle.
I don't know why you guys...
Well, that worked.
...for all this issue here, man.
That's
great. You just got to ask politely.
Hey, turn around.
Okay, well, just do me a favor and step... Yeah, face away from the sound of my voice, and go ahead and walk back till I tell you to stop. Go ahead and keep walking, and stop. All right, officer, the highway patrol officer, can you go ahead and put him in cuffs?
Yep.
We got your cover. Is there another in the vehicle?
Yep.
There's one in the back.
Okay, passenger, if you can hear me, go ahead and step out of the vehicle on the right side.
Okay, don't freaking shoot me.
I don't got a clear shot, so...
I'm moving over.
Okay. All right. Okay, he's out of the car. He got out on the left side. Sorry. All right, let's go ahead and bring this suspect back so we can call this other one back.
Yeah.
All right, sir, follow me.
All right, keep your hands up and don't move until we tell you to. All right, keep walking back to the sound of my voice. Don't face backward or don't face towards me. There you go. Keep going, and stop. All right, you guys got my cover?
Yep.
Covered.
Okay.
All right. I'm going to move up to clear the vehicle.
Okay. Go ahead and clear. Go ahead and walk back here. Come back here.
81, I have your cover.
Yeah, he's not in handcuffs on my screen. I don't know if I properly cuffed him. Come on, keep going back here.
Yeah,
let's go ahead.
Clear. Purple shirt, getting Explorer back here.
Yeah, vehicle's clear.
Okay. I'm going to go ahead and place him in the Tahoe.
All right, I'm going to clean up the code 5.
Let's go ahead and step over here really quick, just so I could understand what exactly happened. So, were they... It was a traffic stop, right?
Correct.
Okay, and it just turned to non-cooperation and stuff like that?
It immediately turned to, they did not want to comply at all with officers. And then they were stopped for 35 plus to start.
Okay.
So, went on ahead, a traffic stop was made, and then, at that time, they kept mentioning operations. They kept mentioning how they didn't want their... the passenger kept mentioning he didn't want his drugs taken.
Okay.
And when asked to step out of the vehicle, he refused. Both refused nonstop.
Okay. Anything in the vehicles, guys? Any drugs or anything?
We got a locked compartment back here. Looks like it's locked with some sort of pass key.
Okay.
Either break it open or get a passcode for them.
Let's see if we can chat with them, see if we can get in there and get a passcode. If not, let's go ahead and see if we could, or we could try to apply for a warrant to get in there, the proper way.
Yeah, well, if he...
Because breaking it open.
Yeah, we can't break it open, but if he'll let us open it, then we can look in there. Otherwise, yeah, we're going to have to warrant that, because that's a separate key to the ignition.
Yeah.
I can contact dispatch and have him contact the judge while you guys speak to him.
Okay, who's the driver, the one in the Tahoe or the one in the Explorer?
That's going to be 2-4 for the Explorer and 7-3 for the Tahoe.
Okay, so the driver was the...
The driver is put in the Explorer.
Okay, perfect. Yeah. How's it going, sir?
It's going well. How about yourself? Yeah,
it's going pretty good. So, the trouble that you were giving my officers, you want to explain that?
We were just going out for a drive just because the license plate is similar to weed.
Well, I wasn't saying anything about the license plate. I'm just asking why you were giving the officers trouble.
Oh, no. I'm explaining why. He suspected that we had drugs in our car just because of our license plate.
Okay. But what about the 35 over that you were going in the on this road right here, on this highway?
We were late. I have to take my son to the doctor's. We were late for an appointment. He has asthma, and we're trying to get him confirmed, prescribed that he has asthma. He's right now using his mother's medication, which is why he didn't want anyone to take it away from him.
Okay. Well, I don't think... Is there a kid in the car somewhere that we didn't see when we scanned it over?
Kid, he's 18.
Oh, okay. So, first of all, he can handle his own situation.
Oh, is that the passenger?
And is that the weed that you guys are talking about, the drugs that you don't want taken?
Yeah, of course. Because it's prescribed to his mother.
Okay. Hey, how's it going in the back of the car right here? You doing all right?
Oh, it's going great, yeah.
Okay, so your father was saying something about drugs being in the car. Do you want to go ahead and tell me what kind of drugs are in the car?
It's just my mom's medication, you know.
What kind of medication is that?
It might be a little bit of cannabis.
Okay, so now I'm really confused. I thought it was... asthma inhalers, and now it's cannabis. How could you use cannabis for asthma?
It clears out the lungs, you know?
And are you smoking the cannabis? So it's going to be flower cannabis? It's going to be actual raw cannabis? Or is it going to be like edibles or something? Yeah, what? I'm confused on the situation.
You know, I'm very confused too.
Okay. All right. Well... If it's flower cannabis, I don't understand how you would be smoking that to help you with asthma because you're smoking something. So, I'm trying to connect the dots
also,
here. It's not making sense.
Do you have a prescription for cannabis, or does your mom have a prescription for cannabis and you're using it?
I'm using my mom's prescribed medication.
Okay, well, that in itself right there is illegal.
She's probably going to lose her...
recommendation.
Her prescription, because she's allowing you to use it, and you're 18, which you could legally go get your own prescription.
And you could be placed in custody for having someone else's prescription in your custody.
Yeah, and your dad is lying and telling us that it's asthma medication, as in, like, inhalers. Not, he didn't mention anything about weed.
Well, you didn't see the asthma medication in the front seat?
Well, it doesn't matter if you're saying something about weed now.
Wow, okay.
All right, well, let's just let him sit and we'll figure it out. So I'm going to talk to the dad again.
Deputy. Yeah, this is...
All right, you told me that there was asthma medication. We just found a whole bunch of weed. And your son's saying that he's using his mother's medication, which is a prescription medication for marijuana. And then we find a whole bunch of marijuana. And you were the driver. And so what's going on? I'm confused here. You're not making much sense.
All right. Going to be honest, my son and I use my wife's prescription to get some marijuana. He does has asthma, but it's not a severe case where smoking it causes. It's more exercise induced.
Well, so, I still don't think marijuana would help asthma in any way, shape, or form. It's just as simple as that. And right now, because you guys are in possession of a prescription that's not lawfully allowed to you guys, we're in a kind of a situation here.
It's pretty much just marijuana at this point.
Yeah, and you actually have... officer, what was the amount again?
6.8 ounces.
6.8 ounces. So that's over the
that's
legal
a lot.
Amount. Yeah, that is a felony amount of marijuana.
Yeah, I mean, we used less. And every time the prescription refill came by, like, we just started collecting it a little.
Okay.
Probably shouldn't have.
Well, at this point, you do understand that someone is going to be going to jail for this felony amount of marijuana.
Yeah, I figured.
Well, then I say we take the father in for intent to resell and the felonious amount of marijuana that he has on him.
Yeah.
And then other than that, I mean, the son, he was clean, right? There was nothing on him during the pat-down or anything like that?
Not that we're aware of. He was pretty clean.
Okay. So what do we want to do with him? Just let him go?
Yeah, cut him loose, arrest the father.
Yeah, that works for me. All right. Well, right now you're going to be let go. Your father's going to be getting arrested for intent to resell and the, you know, felony amount of marijuana he has on him. You're going to be let go at this time. If you need a ride off of the freeway, which actually that's probably what we'll do, so we'll have you sit back in the passenger side of that vehicle. You have any...
One out of one. I'm heading to Sandy Shores. I can go on ahead and take him.
That'll be perfect, yeah. Whatever works. Any questions from you?
No.
All right. Do you have any remorse here that your father's going to jail or anything, or do you not care?
I honestly don't care. I mean, he's kind of protective.
Okay, well, then there you go. So just do me a favor and go ahead and sit in the passenger side of this SUV right here.
So your son is going to be let go. You are the driver of the vehicle, so you're in possession of what's inside, considering that you or him don't have any sort of prescription for the marijuana that you're carrying. It becomes illegal at that point, and you're going to be charged with the felony amount of marijuana. You're probably also going to get a citation for the 35 over, and your vehicle is going to be impounded for the locked box that we cannot get into. We do have a warrant for that, so we're going to be impounding the vehicle.
Did you say you had a warrant for the box?
Yes,
we got a warrant.
Through.
Yeah, so a tow truck's here to tow that vehicle. You will be able to get it out of police impound once we're done with it, but you are going to be booked for that as of right now. You have anything to say about anything?
Yeah, I mean, it wasn't, there's no intent to resell.
Okay, well, found
the
a
ledger,
book
the ledger
that had
says
names
otherwise.
And dollar amounts next to names, and that combined with a large amount of marijuana, the only thing that you're really going to come up with is some sort of bartering, trading, loaning, money, weed. Something has to be going on.
Or maybe I'm a reseller of antique cars.
Well, that has nothing to do with the ledger
with
book
hundred,
that's locked
with,
in a safe.
And has amounts of anywhere from $50 to $200.
And that's the thing is, if that is the case, then that'll all be held through in the court, and you can handle it that way. Other than
that, you can totally fight this.
Yep, this is what's going on right now. So unfortunately, you're going to be arrested from what we're seeing, and then you can handle arrest in court. We can't fight that here anyways.
Yeah, you guys are just the foot soldiers.
Exactly.
Further up.
Yeah.
All right. Well, hope your day gets better, and these officers will take care of you from here.
Yeah, I hope I don't drop the soap.
Yeah, that would be unfortunate. All right, guys. Go ahead and take care of them. We're going to head back into jurisdiction.